Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another fantastic boot review. As you guys saw from the thumbnail and probably the title, this is a crazy pair of football boots. And I gotta tell you, when I saw them at first online, I was not that excited, but I'm gonna tell you why I'm super excited about these. Let's roll the intro. All right, so of course I am talking about the Adidas PredCopX, CopX, however you want to talk about those. They are the amalgamation of, it's like a Frankenstein boot. And so what they've done is they've taken the amazing, amazing, amazing speed frame from the with the Carbotex insert from the X, Adidas X boot. They've put the Copa upper, and then they've put the Demon Skin spikes from the Predator. So the new Predator, it is currently Wednesday the 26th. The new Predator dropped yesterday, so the brand new one. So you, obviously, over time, you won't be able to get those with the Demon Skin spikes. So this has the Demon Skin spikes on a leather upper with a speed boot insole. So it's an awesome concept. I really don't like how they look in photos, but I'm excited to see what they look like in person, and I'm really curious to know what they fit and feel like, because when I reviewed the Copa when I was in Australia still, you can go watch that video, the Copa point one, the Copa Sense point one, I actually really liked how they fit. And the Copa fit my foot really well. It's got a wide enough toe box. It's got stretchiness in the midfoot, so I can actually wear them. So if these fit like a Copa but have the lightness of a speed boot and a leather upper with the grip, I might wear these. Like, I might actually wear these, which is crazy. And I didn't think I was going to want to, but I got my hands on a pair anyway and was like, you know what? Let's just review them and give your honest opinion about what they look like and feel like. So, of course, Adidas, 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 you do such a good job at the limited edition boxes. I absolutely love these. These are so cool. It's that drawer style where you open it up like this, and it's got the limited collection Adidas logo, limited collection. And then this is in my normal size 9 US. As you can see, it's the PredCopX, and they are marketing this as boosting your control, touch, and speed. Like, all of a sudden they've taken three separate categories of boot that they have and thrown them into one, and now they can say this boot does everything perfectly. Not the case, but we'll go from there. So let's open the box. So cool. I love how the drawer opens. That's awesome. Really cool mechanism. And then they've made it stop. Oh, never mind. It doesn't stop. That's okay. Okay, wow. Holy cow. What the hell? All right, there you go. These are crazy looking. So it's got a black leather upper, pink accents on the upper. The Demon Skin spikes are all the hot colors. So the pink, red, yellow, orange. And then they've got a crazy like chrome sole plate on them, which I think is awesome. Of course, they have to put the outsole coating on the bottom of the shoe. Will potentially wear off during play, but will not affect performance of this product. Thank you, Adidas. Nike does the same thing, so no stress. Let's take these out of the box and get the, let's see, the paper as well. I'll take those out. So again, these are a crazy concept. They only produced one colorway of this boot, and that is something that makes them pretty special edition, I think. I don't know if they'll do anything like this again. They may, once they have, obviously, the new Predator out now, and then if they come out with a new Copa, crossing my fingers because the current one is not very good, even though it fits really well, I don't think it's a very good boot, and it's just really chunky. So the fact that they put a crazy, let's do this one, a crazy sole plate on this pretty nice leather upper, like I honestly don't mind it. It's really thick. It's definitely thicker than something like a Tiempo. But it, you know, again, like it's a leather football boot, and that's really all that matters. You've still got those Sense pods right here. This is going to be interesting. See, that's what I didn't know. So you get, just like in the Copa Sense, per the name, you've got this extra level of, and I think, I don't know if it's an actual, yeah, it might actually be a Sense pod. So it's like a foam pod that sits here on the outside and then here on the inside on that passing, kind of that right by the knuckle of your toe, and the big toe, and they've put Demon Skin spikes on top of that. So if you see, I don't know if this is gonna come through, but you've got like a pretty big ridge. And so it you might be able to spin the ball like crazy with these. And I know, yes, I always preach the player is the person who spins the ball, but the demon skin spikes are noticeable when you're trying to whip and bend the ball. Like, they actually make a pretty significant difference. So on a leather upper, I'm super curious. Like, I've been, Josh from Soccer Reviews for You mentioned the other, in one of his videos like a long time ago, he mentioned having a, wow, just completely lost my train of thought. I was going somewhere with this. Oh, yeah, the demon skin spikes. So basically that the demon skin spikes actually offer sustainable, like it actually makes a difference in the way that you kick a ball because you have to get used to how sticky this is. I mean, you can, like you can hear that. I mean, that. It, I mean, it's raised quite a bit on the upper. These are, I'll see if I can get these untied a little bit. Yeah, and again, the Sense Pods on the original Copa that I reviewed, those white, those like crazy white colorway, I don't remember what they were called, but they were okay. They, you know, again, like it had, I had a little bit of heel slippage, but not a ton. And I wore the Plus variation, the Sense Plus, for a training session. And I didn't find them to be that bad for heel slippage, but they weren't good enough. And I think having the laces on there will be super, super cool. Once you get the laces untied, again, pretty it's like a very standard Copa, but then it's got the crazy demon skin spikes. Same tongue as the Copa, same like Sense Pods all over here, same Sense Pods in the back, except it's suede. So I think these might be like really nice. It actually might sit really nicely in my heel. And then of course you've got this amazing carbon fiber sole plate. I love this sole plate so much. And I think they are such a, they did such a good job with these, which is awesome. So yeah, crazy colorways. Let me know down in the comments below what you guys think of this color. I think it would have been better if they had gone with a, let's just even say they went, instead of a black leather, they went white leather. White leather with the pink accents would have looked super, super cool. Made it a little bit more clean, a little bit fresher, and a little bit more like pop. But the black contrasted so dramatically with the pink, and then you've got these crazy like demon skin spikes. I think it definitely, it makes you look and you're like, what the hell are those? But it's not my favorite colorway, put it that way. Definitely not my favorite colorway. They are kind of wild, but let me know what you think down in the comments below. Would you buy these if they were readily available? Like if Adidas just started making this as one of their boots, would you buy these? I don't know. I'm interested to see how they fit and feel on feet. None of the technology that I've discussed here today and or is in this boot is stuff that is new. It's all stuff that Adidas has in their current models. So that's something to keep in mind when, if you do want to buy these, if you really like the feel of the Copa SensePoint 1 upper, you'll probably fit great in these, except it'll be a little bit of a different sensation, obviously touching the ball because of how grippy the upper is. And then of course you'll have far more acceleration feel with this sole plate, and it's a much more aggressive sole plate than the SensePoint 1. So that's something to keep in mind as you're, if you want to buy these. I know because of how frankly ugly they look, not a lot of people ended up buying these. I think a lot of people thought like, what an awesome concept, but like if you had executed this better, I think they would have, like the colorway, if you had done all black or all white or done, you know, something really, or let's even say a flashy colorway, but you could have done, still kept the pink, but again, do a white upper or do something like a, I don't know, like an even crazier colorway, but that doesn't just include like black leather. I think that's the thing that throws it off, is like you've got this crazy sole plate that's chrome and you've got this pink accent and you've got these wild like flame fire colors on the demon skin spikes, and then it's just like a black leather upper. Like, what are you thinking? And I get that they want to display each piece of these, but like Adidas, you guys are actually really good at doing colorways. I think a lot of your colorways are super good, especially on the current models of football boots. Come on, you could have done better, hey? So how these fit and feel is a complete mystery to me, and I am really, really intrigued. So let's hop into the on-feet portion of the video of the Adidas PredCopX in the firm ground variation. Here we go. All right, fam. So with me, I've got the Adidas PredCopX, or CopX, Copa, yeah, CopX in a size 9 US. This is the size that I wear for the Copas, the Predators, and the X Speed Flow 0.1 and pluses. So makes sense, size 9, right? I'm very excited to try these on. I cannot wait to get these on my feet, especially if they feel at all like a Copa. I think I will absolutely adore playing in these. Without further ado, let's get this suspense out of the way. Oh, no way. These are crazy. Okay, my feet fit perfectly. Not perfectly, but like they slid right in. Like, unbelievable. No freaking way, man. Let's see how the right one gets in there. Ooh, kind of tight, but that's all right. No stress. Oh my goodness, guys. Plenty of width in the forefoot. Midfoot is a bit tight, but definitely would stretch because it is leather. Oh man, no way. I just might have found a gem. These are so cool and they fit so well. The heel I'm already noticing is much better than the normal Copa. I don't know if they did anything differently, but they definitely feel better, that's for sure. Okay, we're gonna tie these tight, see how they fit and feel with the laces tied tight, and we'll go from there. Man, my right foot is like kind of swollen. That's weird. Feels a lot tighter than my left, which is very strange, but that's okay. Okay, so get these on. Double knot always for the win. I don't think I've ever had my shoelaces come untied in a game. Definitely in training, but not in the game. Okay. Wow. These are such a unique sensation, like super wide, but then it has this like the crazy springiness of that carbon fiber sole plate. Now, the moment of truth is what's gonna make the difference between a really crappy boot and a really interesting good boot is what they feel like with the ball, because that's where those demon skin spikes come in. Okay, don't really notice them that much. But I'm sure with juggling Wow. Okay, these are really cool and they fit so well. That's wild. Like genuinely, they fit so good. The sole plate is super springy. I love how this sole plate, I mean, you guys know it was my second top boot of the year of 2021 was the X Speed Flow, and part of that is because of this amazing sole plate that kind of keeps you on your toes and keeps you really like nimble and agile. But the leather upper on these is it's not incredible. As I said before in the previous part of the video when I was holding it, it's just a good leather upper. It's not an amazing leather upper. It's not an Mizuno leather upper. It's not even Nike leather upper, but it's just fine leather upper that'll do great. There's not really any space in between the top of the boot and the collar area and the ankle, which is huge. That's a really big deal for me. And the feel and the touch on the ball is actually really, really good. I'm interested to see how I go shooting with this boot, but so far, man, these are crazy. These are so cool. If nothing else, they're a really interesting sensation on feet. I don't know if I'll ever wear these in a game, but I think I'll start training in these every once in a while, just because they are something different, something fun, and they include a bunch of different pieces of some of my favorite boots, including those Predator Freaks, which were the 2021 honorable mention, and then of course the Speed Flow Plus and 0.1 sole, the carbon fiber insert, Carbotex insert, and that was the number two boot of the year. So fantastic fitting boot. Go true to size because it is a Copa at the end of the day, so it does fit, you know, pretty true to size. It's got a pretty wide toe box, which is awesome. I love that. And yeah, guys, these are super cool. They fit my feet actually really well, which is awesome. Yeah, man, I am really impressed by these, and I'm also very excited to keep these around and start to train in them and play in them, because I think these the demon skin spikes add a little bit of something to the outside of a leather boot, like a normal leather boot, and that is it. So that is it for the video, guys. Thanks so much for joining me again for this awesome review, unboxing, and on feet of the PredCopX from Adidas. This wild amalgamation of all the coolest features of each of the boots.
If you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already. As always, be awesome, take care. I'll see you guys in the next video.